So, we got to talk. Shelly-Ann, 10.63. Olympics going to be quite interesting come July, man. I'm excited. What's going on, y'all? It's your boy, K-Ray. No More TNF, fourth installment. If you haven't already, like, share, subscribe. That's the most important part. Let's get these subscribers up. Everybody that not already subscribed to the channel, thank you so much. It's greatly appreciated. But let's get into it. I low-key don't even want to watch the men's 100 meter final come Tokyo. I'm gonna watch it. Of course, I'm gonna watch it. But the women's race has gotten so much more compelling, man. So much more compelling. Whoo, man! Oh goodness. So to put in perspective, what just happened this weekend? Got to go down to Jamaica. We in Kingston, the National Stadium. Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, double Olympic champion, 2008 and 2012. She won world titles in 09, I want to say 2011, 13. She won in 19. She may have won in either 15 or 17. I can't remember. Like, this isn't even arguably. Like, Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce is the GOAT of women's sprinting, like, especially like 100 meter. Like, her 100 meter prowess is second to none. The only thing she doesn't have is the world record, which that's so far and gone out there. Like, Flo-Jo's 10:49 is just so far out there. And I don't know, man, here in the next month and a half, she may even own the world record. The way Shelly-Ann, the way Sha'Carri, the way Elaine Thompson dropped 10:78 this season already. Then you got Dina Asher-Smith from Great Britain. I think she dropped 10:92. Tiana Bartoletta, she just dropped 10:96 this past weekend. Yo, this women 100 meter final in Tokyo is about to be ignorant. It's about to be bananas. Like, it's gonna be more exciting than the men's 100 meter final. And the way Jamaica is looking, because they got a few other athletes outside of Shelly-Ann and Elaine Thompson. Honestly, the 4x1 world record might go. The 40-82 that the U.S. women, anchored by Carmelita Jetter, their world record set in London 2012. It may be over, man. Jamaica might go 40.5. It's going to take, in the women's final, it's going to take 10:57 or under to win the gold. Whew, man, I don't know. Shelly-Ann did her thing. She's 34 years of age. She's been doing this, like, at an elite level since 2008. Her reign as sprint queen is going on almost 15 years. Almost a decade and a half. Like, it's unfathomable to think how many global titles, it's unfathomable to think how many global titles she has stacked up. To have 13 years of longevity is one thing, but to be dominant for 13 years, man, it's something different. It is different. She is a creative player. A month ago, everybody thought Sha'Carri was the clear-cut favorite to take gold come Tokyo. With Sha'Carri, like, don't get me wrong, the girl is a beast. Also, the Twitter back and forth is is something to watch. We don't really see much of that in track and field, so it's refreshing to see. Also, if y'all hear any noise, it's my dishwasher. I promise I'm not. Cleanliness is next to godliness, so always remember that. It's 100 meter final for the women. The ladies are coming to play this summer, and it's exciting to see. This world record might go, and I don't know who gonna do it. Let's start a poll. I put it on Twitter. I'm gonna re-put it on Twitter. Let's start a poll. I asked the question. I'm probably gonna ask it again closer to the Olympics. But who do you guys think is gonna take 100 meter gold for the women? It's gonna be Shelly-Ann, the GOAT. Gonna be Elaine Thompson. She's the defending Olympic champion from Rio, and she's gone 10:07. Is it gonna be Sha'Carri Richardson? Is it gonna be Dina Asher-Smith from Great Britain? Which she is my pick to win in the 200, which I'll get into that in a different video. Or is it gonna be the field? Is it gonna be somebody else that we ain't even talked about yet? But let's go back. That 10:63, man, that is the second fastest time in women's history. Flo-Jo's world record, 10:49, all the way out there. I think she's ran 10:54 as well. Both of those she did in the 88 season. The 10:49 she ran at the Olympic trials, 10:54, if I'm not mistaken, she ran at the 88 Seoul Olympics. Those two marks, far and away, just boom. Nobody has gotten within, just the first time somebody has gotten even within a tenth of a second of the 10:54, let alone the 10:49. Carmelita Jetta back in 09, she ran 10:64. I want to say Marion Jones ran 10:65. Outside of that, I don't believe anybody else has ran under 10.7. Shelly-Ann has a laundry list of times in the 10.7 range. This is the first time she's gone under 10.7. And when I say she went under 10.7, she dipped under 10.7. 10.63 at the age of 34. That is ignorant. That is crazy to think about. So come Tokyo, come this 100-meter women's final, it's going to be must-see TV, man. I'm not even going to call it right now. I have no idea. I got kind of an idea what the final may look like, but I have no idea who's going to take the gold, man. So, yeah, down in the comments, y'all let me know. I'm going to put a poll up on Twitter. Be sure to follow me on Twitter, the real K Ray underscore. And, yeah, maybe we're going to have this conversation later on. No more TNF signing off.